Hi, I'm Jeanette, and I'm using virtual reality to investigate decision-making behavior in different neighborhood environments. My research focuses on health behavior, risk-taking, and decision-making, and I'm particularly interested in the role that early life stress plays in these decision-making behaviors. This project was inspired by previous correlational studies that have shown that residents who live in deprived neighborhoods tend to make more short-term focused decisions, and they also tend to take more risks. With this project, we want to investigate how cues in a neighborhood, such as danger and low safety, impact risk-taking and decision-making, and what role early life stress plays in this process. When taking part in the study, participants are randomly allocated to one of the two VR conditions. One condition is a deprived neighborhood. This neighborhood contains lots of cues of danger, low safety, and social conflict. The other condition is a scene of a neighborhood that does not contain any cues of danger and low safety. Participants follow directions and walk through the neighborhood for 7 minutes. At the end, they perform a risk-taking and decision-making task right in the VR environment. The Balloon Analogue Risk Task, also called BART, is a behavioral risk-taking task that has been around for about 20 years. Performance on the BART is correlated with self-reported occurrence of addictive, health, and risk-related behaviors. In our version of the BART, participants interact with the tasks in VR. They are presented with a series of balloons, and for each balloon, they can decide how much to inflate it. Participants have to make a trade-off decision between trying to win as many points as possible, but also playing it safe to avoid losing points when a balloon explodes. Usually, participants perform these tasks in a neutral environment on a computer in a lab setting. This approach is often criticized for having low ecological validity, which means that because participants perform the tasks in a neutral artificial lab environment, they might behave differently from how they would usually behave in the real world. Using VR for this project as a method really enables us to design the environments and the cues in the environments exactly how we need them to be, so that the environments are as realistic as possible and we can test the theory that we are working with. The biggest advantage and the really innovative aspect of this project is that we embedded the risk-taking and the decision-making tasks directly in VR, so we can measure behavior while participants are exposed to cues from the virtual environment. We expected that exposure to the deprived neighborhood would increase risk-taking and short-term focused decision-making for those participants who have experienced early life stress. However, in our sample, there was almost no one who experienced early life stress, and therefore we could not detect this effect. But what we found was that there were significant differences between the two conditions regarding how participants felt when they were in the VR environment. In the deprived neighborhood, participants felt less safe and more stressed. So this shows that the cues in the deprived neighborhood had a big impact on how participants felt. In the future, this project could be used to investigate to what extent decision-making processes of disadvantaged groups are influenced by cues of danger from the environment. For example, we could use the two neighborhoods to investigate the effect on people's behavioral investments in their future. For example, by maintaining health or by saving for retirement. This is relevant because we know that these behaviors have an influence on premature mortality and contribute to socioeconomic health disparities. But more applied research questions are also possible. For example, we could investigate the decision-making processes of first responders, like police or firefighters, because these professions are oftentimes faced with cues of danger. This project is an exciting first step towards using behavioral tasks in VR, and it shows the huge potential of this method for both foundational as well as applied behavioral sciences.